Hello, everybody. Welcome to Cigar Review TV. I'm your host, Damon Pettit, and this is a different location, undisclosed, because I could get arrested. Just kidding. It is just this nice, quaint office area. I was going to do it at a different hotel place, but they had something going on, so kind of made it to where I wasn't even going to chance it. So, let me see here. We have today the Camacho Corojo Toro. And look at that beautiful, beautiful red. Looks like somebody painted that, you know? Just painted it on there. It's got that scorpion somewhere in there. Yeah, it's like right there. Which, there are plenty of those out here. Hopefully I won't be, getting stung or anything by any of those today. There are some bugs flying around, so that could be fun. This is supposed to have a very strong flavor here. I'm gonna be pairing it with a coffee, just a plain coffee with some cream, a little bit of sugar. Okay, that's okay. I don't use as much sugar as I used to, so let's just get this baby going. The website is pretty cool. I'll have a link of that. Not bad so far, a quick little nice smoke. Very nice draw. Very, very decent draw there. I'm missing something here. Jesus. Hello. If I do that again, the fire department might show up. Let me see. Just in case you couldn't see, there we go. Camacho. Pretty easy to see. This is a Toro. And, it is 100% Corojo. Wrapper, biller. Wrapper, filler, binder. This one also has a little bit of an easy draw, like a little bit too easy, but it seems to be doing okay here. We'll see. I like a little bit more. You want to call it a pull to it, so that it's not so easy, but I'm not gonna let that. Just want to see what this is burning like here. Not bad. I've lit it pretty good. Saturday night, it is 8 o'clock, and people, which is unbelievable. My dad fucking gets up. He wins all the time. He's like, today he's like, look, I put 15 bucks. Fuck you. Every time I want to.
We have visitors.
So, and he, every time, well, he won 25 bucks last week and he won 15 bucks this week.
Taking a stroll.
which is cool. Just hanging out. Now, I just updated my, operating system or whatever for my iPhone. For me, I was very disappointed in the stupid little icons, but I'm getting over that, at least the look of it. I don't like some of it. I'll show you. The main thing I don't like, let's see if we can get it shown here. It might not show up. There we go. The empty square parts, they're kind of all light brown. I don't like that very much. And I hate the clock. The calendar thing. It's you can see the 21 right up in here. I just don't like that font right there. And it's so thin you can't even hardly see it. Anyway, so I ranted about that real quick on, I believe, a thing I did on Twitter. Probably everywhere. But I like a lot of the different things, the functionality of it. So that's good. I guess that's the part that really counts. Still not exactly sure why they changed the icon part so much, but that's just me being a crybaby about something that really doesn't matter. So we do need to send out our tweet as usual to all you. But cigar so far, not bad. A nice full body cigar, full body taste. Very woodsy. Woodsy kind of taste. Burn is just kind of okay right now. It's the natural. It's not a Maduro. But not bad. It goes with my coffee very well. And like I said, the draw on it's very easy. So far it's not losing. Staying wet, which is good. I have a couple humidors. The one I keep when I do reviews, I know I'm going to do reviews on cigars, I keep those in a humidor that always stays right at about 70, couple ticks below maybe, but it's usually right about 70. And the humidity. And so they stay properly humidified, which is good. I don't want to destroy a cigar and then do a review on it and make the cigar look bad at all. I really do like that bold red look. They're just saw my own shadow, almost scared me. might have just saw a rabbit too. Out here I see a lot of rabbits, a lot of coyotes. The other day I saw a frog, and then the next day I saw another frog, but it was dead, so I don't know if it was the same frog or not. I'm hoping not. Just a little frog. But I've never, I don't know. Arizona, you don't think you're gonna see frogs everywhere. A couple more people down that way, which is fine. I'm all for people as long as they don't try to screw with me. Or take my cigar, then I'd have to get ugly. Wow. it's an actual family now. We thought a little business park would have so many people walking through it. Here we go. It's beyond me, the amount of people that will come by someplace sometimes. We'll wait until they go by before we keep doing this. But it's okay. Sorry for the silence, but I don't want to go a little too crazy, though. I'm not too happy. I'm not unhappy with this cigar, but again, the rolling of this cigar seems to be a little bit too loose, and I think that's going to end up playing with the way it stays lit and all. We'll see. It's not as strong as I was expecting it to be. On the site they have it as like almost all the way to the end of the strength, their little strength meter. And it's got a little strength to it, but I don't know. Can you see? It's really irritating to me. This is the second time, I believe, in a row now, actually, that having a problem with the roll of a cigar. Tell it's getting ready to go out. Give it a chance. Not gonna fuck with it yet. But I can tell I'm not getting half the smoke. It's like it's just barely something staying lit there. Let me send this out. Reviewing. Let's do it by words here. Reviewing a Camacho Corojo Toro cigar. What the fuck? It did not work. Great, so it's not working with that. So I won't be doing that. Screw it. It's honestly beyond me. I'm having this problem again. Another cigar I was really looking forward to. I'll probably buy one more just to see if I have the same problem. Like I've always said, you know, cigars are handmade. They're always going to be a little bit different. They're not going to be perfect every time. So I'm not going to cast it off into the abyss of shit. But I will try it again. You never know. It might come to as well. So I'm not going to... It's not a bad cigar at all. Now I can't remember what I paid for it. I'll have that in the description and on the screen as well. So I just want to remind everybody that I do have a website, and it's called CigarReviewTV.com. So if you ever, YouTube has given me some sort of problems now with having it on mobile. So you can go to my site on your mobile phone. You'll be able to, the latest review will be on there. I'm trying to, I gotta get it so that I can have all my reviews on there. So it's a lot, and I've gotta figure out how to get them in there. Really irritating. So you could, if for some reason you go to YouTube and it's showing that it can't play on the phone or what else, it says TV maybe, you can go to my site, CigarReviewTV.com, and you can see it there, no problem. I use Vimeo for the actual feed. Like, I'll download my the video to Vimeo as well, and then from there it sucks it into my site. So you could also go to Vimeo.com and you could look at Cigar Review TV there, and you can see my reviews there. I have almost all of them on there, all of my reviews with the exception of, I believe, one. I think I lost one because I did, for some reason, I didn't retain the copy, the original of mine, and YouTube completely muted it, and there's no way to reverse it, so I ended up having to just delete that one, and bye-bye. Still going, that's good. I thought for sure it was losing it again. A little bit of almost like a cherry wood taste right there. Interesting. It does have a small bit of a bite, not a lot. It is got a strength to it, but it's not a strong, strong cigar. They have three people, and I don't exactly know what these people do. They might be kind of ambassadors for their cigar. One of them is Mike Ditka. I wrote the other down. Matt Booth, who is Room 101. That cigar is the founder of that. And then Rob Weiss, who is a screenwriter, producer, and director. So those three people, and they call him, hold on again, the Board of the Bold. So any of you who don't know who Mike Ditka is, he was a football player, played for the Bears. I don't know if he played for anybody else, but he's in the Hall of Fame. He was also Chicago Bears coach, and took them to the Super Bowl. Is it their only? Took them to their only winning Super Bowl, and I'm sure that got to be the majority of people. Anybody who happens to be watching this at all knows who he is, but just in case. He also, I believe, coached for New Orleans Saints for a couple seasons, maybe, and didn't do so well there. But he's a pretty popular figure. I got to see him in person once and wasn't real thrilled. It was right after Dan Reeves, who was the coach of the Broncos for a long time, he got canned, and they were doing this big roast for him at the sports arena. So me and my buddy Vince who you guys have seen every now and then on here. We went down there to try to see who was going to be there, and so we saw John Elway, of course, was there, and Gary Kubiak, who at that time was still playing football as well. He's now the Houston Texans head coach. And I'll go over this quick. Tom Landry was there. Mike Ditka was there. And, of course, when you go to an event like that, he's got to know that there's going to be people asking for autographs. And he, you know, he's got real bad knees, so he kind of wobbles back and forth as he walks. And the whole time, he's like, this should be illegal. This should be illegal. He didn't really care to be signing autographs. I didn't get one from him. I didn't get one from anybody there, actually, but kind of just wanted to get pictures and stuff like that. And but that was pretty, wasn't in a very good mood. That's good. It's good. Staying lit now. I like that. Different flavor coming through. I like that. It's very nice. I'm going to say this could be like a $9 cigar, which if it is, that's a decent price. It might be less, might be a little bit more, but we'll see. But that's my guess. I bought this a couple weeks ago, so I don't remember at the moment. And I forgot to check when I was getting ready to do this. It's got a nice aroma. Decent aroma. It's got some nice tobacco going on it. I believe the, sorry, I didn't mean to yawn. That was a little bit rude. The wrapper is made up of the, I can't remember now, the primings that they say. I believe it's the first five or something like that. I don't know if I wrote that down. If I did, I don't know. But, it's beautiful. The weather out of here is getting better and better. They're making a big deal about the weather on the news. They actually did a whole thing about it twice, showing how it's going to be getting cooler as it gets into December. I don't know how stupid they think people are, but yeah, it gets cool here. It's in the high in the 60s. You know, that's not, it's definitely cooler. It's just real weird that they made such a big deal out of it. It's like maybe they knew that there was an influx of new people living here now. I don't know, but really wanted to go to this resort that is a little closer to here, and they had something going on. It was packed. I'm either hallucinating or I keep seeing a rabbit, just like, maybe not. We'll see. I have this sitting on this little light pole, and so when I'm done with this, I'll show you all kind of around what I'm sitting on. Right back there, you can see my little car over here. And just got another car, actually. And kind of suits the roommate situation and everybody, so it's a little bit bigger car. Toyota Camry. Pretty nice. Not bad. Not bad. It's a 2011, so. But, it's a good deal. Yeah, it's a Starbucks. I'm not real picky on the different places I go to get coffee. I like it to be a nice, you know, well done, nicely done coffee. Pete's Coffee is very good coffee as well. I've never seen a Pete's Coffee place out here. They're out in Colorado, though. Oh, wait. There is a Pete's Coffee here at the airport. I thought that was in Colorado. It was here at the airport. Because before I flew out to Colorado, this last time, I stopped there and had myself a nice coffee. Smoking okay. It's, you know, burn line, not perfect. But it is, it's hanging in there. The roll on it's not, it's okay. I was a little bit, you know, you get all hyped up to smoke a cigar, and if there's something off on it, it kind of can be a bummer. I mean, if you smoke like 3-4 cigars a day or something like that, I smoke a couple a week now, right now, with everything that's going on with me. So, you know, the two that I smoke during the week, I want them to be good. That same cherry wood combination is in there. You know, the coffee has a little bit to do with it. It's gonna have that espresso kick to it a little bit. It's nice, definitely nice. Do like if you are interested in their what they have, the Camacho brand, you should go to their website and take a look at that as well. I like it when a company has a presence on the web as well, just because, you know, it's kind of a big thing nowadays. Getting on, I don't expect everybody to be online all the time, obviously. But it's a very good tool, and it's a tool that free advertising, you know. And I mean, I have mine, and I don't even sell anything but besides just myself. And it's not like I'm getting paid. I've been given some free cigars here and there, which I'm more than thankful for. I never ever expected anybody to ever send me a cigar. And there's a few of you that have sent me cigars, and there's a couple actual cigar companies that have, and I'm very thankful for that. It's very, you know, a little bit more excitement. Say hi to Mark, Cigars and Cars. Looking forward to the next one. If none of you have seen it, you should take a look. If you like to kind of, sorry, I got an itch. If you like to kind of sit back, it was a bus. If you like to sit back, relax, and kind of watch, you know, kind of like what I'm doing as far as just hanging out and talking. If you go on the web and go to YouTube, and you can see Cigars and Cars, I believe is what it is, I'm pretty sure. And oh my God, come on. You probably look that up and find him. Oh my God. I know what I'm saying. I can't. Can't find it. The his actual channel name. I wanna. I can just throw it up right quickly and move on right now, obviously. But I want to at least. Not even going to be. it's still smoking okay there. The ash is definitely Let's find it. Let's get this done. Sorry, everybody. But that's part of what I do. I don't, like, cut it off or anything, so you have to just suffer. You gotta suffer with me. Because, trust me, I am suffering right now. I just want to have his... Yeah, I knew something was... MGB squared. So, let's click on him. MGB squared. I don't know if you can see him, but you should go there. Because he kind of does it just off the cuff as well. Just when he can. Does it. He's got a couple in the can now, I believe. So, check it out. Oh my god. Like I said, it's very beautiful out here. It's starting to, like now when I go in to where I work, I leave very early. It's like 75 degrees out now, so it's nice. Don't like almost like die of sweat. Thing is giving me a push-pull love you hate you effect here, because it's like starts to, you know, be real nice and then let it go for not even a minute and it gives me a problem. I am actually using my iPhone 4 for doing the review. I now use it like an iTouch because I don't have phone service to it, but I could still use the Wi-Fi if I want to, and obviously all the different things on when you're on Wi-Fi, you could use it just that same way. I have some movies on it, and I do these on it, but I was able to update that as well. So hopefully everything's coming out okay. Since I did that, I just did it last night. It's the first thing I've done with it, so we'll see if it works. Football season is going well for me. I'm not as massively into football as I've always have been before, but I still root for my team, the Denver Broncos. They're doing well, and we'll see how far they go. You know, they did really well last year and lost the first game of the playoffs, so it doesn't really matter how good you do if you tank in the playoffs. But each game in themselves are kind of fun to watch. This coming Monday, actually, I believe it's Monday, they're playing the Raiders, and that's a rivalry. And here comes they're after me, I knew it. I'm sure you could probably hear that. There's been twice now on my way to work that there's been activity of somebody that's been hit. And by a car. One day, which was like about a month and a half ago, I had all this stuff blocked off. Of course, I would ride my bike. And there's a couple, apparently, that was hit by some kind of truck. And I'm talking like 4 o'clock in the morning. The guy didn't run away or anything, so it's not like he did it on purpose. It was an accident. I'm trying to figure out, what are these people doing? Because this is where this first one was. It's not like you can't see anything. It's well lit. There's actually an IHOP right there in the corner. And I don't know. I don't know what happened. I hope they lived, but they were in very critical condition, I guess, at that point. And it just makes me wonder, how do you get hit at that time in the morning? There's really no cars. Honestly, I have to go by there every morning on my bike. And I'm very cautious, but there's never hardly any traffic coming by. And when there is, you can easily see them. So I don't know how that all happened. And then again, it happened last night, or actually early this morning, and I went by it, and they were just putting the person into the ambulance, and that person did not make it. They died. He was apparently on one of those little motorized scooter, I don't know, it's almost like a skateboard with a stick on it, but it had a little motor on it. Apparently he just was going against the light, and the person didn't expect to see him, I'm sure, there. But I'm trying to figure out what that guy was thinking too, because again, it's very early, not a lot of traffic. Be careful, people. Just be careful. If you out there, just be careful. Oh.
Yeah.
I'm trying to understand this. I really am. Like I said, I'll get another one. I've enjoyed it enough, and it's got enough flavor where I'll get another one, and I'll see how that one smokes and stuff. I don't know when I'm going to get that other one, but if I get it in the near future and I smoke it, and if it's different than this one, I'll come back and I'll make an addendum and add it on to this review so that you all know. And I'll even do a quick little review update or something like that, break into it or something, I don't know. But I mean, would I recommend this cigar? If it's not over $10, for me, yeah, I would. The flavor's nice. Like I said, the draw is a little bit off. That's the only drawback for me. And that's just, like I said, you know, like we all know, hand-rolled, nothing's going to be perfect. But, so. It's a nice flavor, though. And if you're just sitting around, hanging out, lighting it, again, isn't going to hurt it. The draw isn't too bad. There is some resistance on the draw, so it's not like I'm just sucking through a straw like I've done before. So all in all, feel pretty good about the cigar, and I would recommend trying it. I really would. If you're a beginner, you might go to something a little less strength, maybe. It's not as strong a cigar as I was expecting it to be, so if you end up getting one, you'll be okay, but just, it's not like a light cigar. I do like that wrapper, though. It's so red. Easy to see. I like the scorpion on it. Me and scorpions have a little thing. Been stung too many times. So that one will go in my little thing. My thing I keep them in. I started laminating the ones that I did for these shows, and I stopped doing that. Got to be a bit of a hassle. Well, it's Saturday, and I'm going to hang out. Oh, I'll show you around real quick, too. But I'm going to hang out, relax, and enjoy the rest of this cigar. Hi, thank you very much for watching. Like always, I know you don't have to. You can be doing 1,000 other things. So thank you very much for taking the time to sit there, hang out with me. If you're smoking a cigar, I hope you've had a good cigar. I hope you have a nice drink of coffee or kapuka, something, whatever you like. You know, some whiskey, wine, port, water, urine. There's probably one person out there that actually drinks urine. So, I just included that person. So let me show you around just real quick. So, just hang on. Okay.
This is where you were sitting, right here. Okay. That was not easy. Right down there was a nice little view, I like that. The road is out that way. There's a truck. You can see that part. Goes all the way out into the parking lot. Over here, my car. That's where I was sitting. And here I am. So, I hope everybody's having a good evening or day or whatever time it is, and I hope life is treating you well. And if you're in the downtime, understand that those do not last forever. So as long as you hold out, hang in there, you'll be fine. Things always will get better. They can get worse before they get better. Don't forget about that, but they will get better. So hang in there. If you are having a rough time, take care of yourself. And if you're having a good time, just be thankful for it and keep having a good time. I'll be smoking with you soon. More than likely.